Hello everyone! Today I'm going to show you how you can draw this can of cola with Adobe Illustrator. We are going to use lots of tools, like the Pathfinder tool, the Shear tool, or the Stroke Outline tool. So, let's get to it! Before you get started with the basic shape, make sure we have Smart Guides activated, so our objects will align nicely. We start with the basic ellipse, draw it like this, and we're going to copy this one and we press Alt and Shift to have it aligned directly beneath. Next, we're going to switch to the rectangle tool. And again, we make a big rectangle across our complete can. We can now select all of those three elements. And with the Pathfinder tool, if you don't have this right here, you find it under Windows. We can now select this mode here. This will divide all the objects. We then right click on group and you see now that we have here single objects. The top and the bottom one, we can delete those. And we select the two shapes here and we're going to merge those. You can already see this looks kind of like a Coke can. Use the direct selection tool and by pressing shift, we can make it a bit wider. Maybe this should be fine. Let's put some color on here. Of course, the can will be red. And this might be a bit gray, silver looking like. Let's zoom in here and we're going to make the lid. For doing this, we're going to lock this layer and we create a new one. So we just are not messing around with the background shape here. Let's select the pen tool. And now it's advisable to turn off the smart guides again. And we click and drag to get a basic shape for the lid. Maybe this looks okay. We can do some more adjustments with the direct selection tool. Doesn't need to be too fancy because the Coke can isn't very big, so it doesn't have to be extremely detailed. This should be already fine. We can zoom out again. And we can unlock the layer and make sure that this one here is on the same layer. And we can also group the complete thing by right-clicking and clicking on group. Now we want to get some font on here, some text, so maybe which says Coca-Cola. So to do this, I have installed a font which is freely available on a website which is called DaFont. So you can download the font here. You will find the link in the YouTube description of this video and you download the font, pretty much double click on the file and this will install the font on your system. You can go then back into Illustrator and in here we select our type tool and write down Coca-Cola. You notice that the C here is a bit wrong, so we can delete it and this font has installed some special characters. You can find them under type, glyphs, and in here we for example can insert a C which looks a bit nicer. This already looks quite good. We can scale it up and we keep pressing shift so the proportions of the font will stay correctly and we change the font color to white. Let's maybe also create outlines. This way we can then ungroup the object and we can move this up a bit so it's aligned with the rest of the font. Let's get the can out of the way and I would say we group the cola here. We also can group things by pressing Command G and we reduce the size of this coca here. If we would look at the reference, there's also a little square here so we can add that as well. Let's zoom in a bit and we draw a basic rectangle. And then we can use the shear tool. And by pressing shift, I can then make sure that this is only shifted in one direction. Something like this will be fine. It comes close to the original thing. Let's zoom out again. And we can now put this on our can of Coke. Let's rotate it. And I think this doesn't look too bad. We can also get this specific stripe pattern on the side here. This is again included in the font. We can go on glyphs and let's click on this one. Let's rotate it. We increase the size. Again, create outlines, make this one white. And we put it under here like this. We can also copy this shape here. You can access the grouped object by double clicking on it. Then we copy this shape and press escape again. And then we're going to activate smart guides again. And now we can fit this above the other thing to cut off the edges of this white stripe here. Let's take a closer look at this object here. We select this object and we go on Object, Path, Outline, Stroke. Then we can select this one and the white shape in the background. And we use the trim option down here. Now we can ungroup this again. And we're just going to delete the shapes which are not really necessary. So, this should be fine, and here we have our finished can of Coke. Alright, thank you for watching, see you next time!